understood now. Yesterday also I was explaining the same thing. Today also I am going to start another concept from same chapter, but I want to check the previous knowledge. Yes or no? So that's why I'm going to start with our yesterday's chapter, yesterday's concept. Okay, student? Now till clear everyone here? Okay. Now, student, I'm going to share you one PPT. Okay. Today I'm going to try to share the PPT. Wait a second. How much it's uploading properly in front of you? That I don't know, but I'm going to try. Wait a second. It's a one PPT. In this PPT, various types of fractions given to you. Okay. Fractions types. And in deeply, we want to learn today. What is the fraction? Wait a second, student. Yes. Just a second. Okay, today also same problem is there, that PPT is not working properly. Don't worry, I am going to share you one image. With the help of image, we will understand. Don't worry. Wait a second, student. Yes. Now look at here, one image I'm going to share you, that is yesterday also I was showing you, and today also again I'm going to show you, okay, that image. It's related to fraction part. It's related to fraction part. Wait a second. One part yesterday was shown you, that is all fractions are given to you. Okay. Simple fraction, mixed fraction, all parts are given to you. See, look at here. Yes. Now my screen is visible to everyone. Yes. Give me answer. My screen is visible to everyone. I want answer. Huh? I want answer in chat box. Yes, students, give me response. Am I audible properly? My screen is visible properly. Okay. We can start to our next. Our first one already over. What is the fraction? Okay. Now next concept is proper fraction. Now I'm going to show you proper fraction. There are how many types of fraction? Three types are there. That is proper fraction, improper fraction, and mixed fraction. Okay. Proper fraction. I'm going to ask you at the last moment. Okay. How many types are there in fraction and what is the name of that? So give concentration properly. I'm going to ask you the question at the last 10 minutes. First one is proper fraction. Second one is improper fraction. Third one is mixed number. Third one is what? Mixed number. Okay, student? Yes. Now look at here. In the proper fraction, that already we learned. In the proper fraction, first one number indicates a numerator. Second one number is indicates a denominator. So the numerator is less than the denominator. In the proper fraction, always the numerator is less than the denominator. Understood? This thing you want to keep in mind. Numerator is always less, is always small as compared to denominator. So now example is given to you. In a circle, how many parts are visible to you? Tell me. Now I'm going to highlight with red color. Wait a second. Just tell me, in this circle, how many parts are there? Equal parts are there. Yes, four are there. Okay. And how many colored? Yes. How many color part is there?
one. So you're writing there 1/4. Okay. Otherwise 1/4. 1/4. Otherwise 1/4. Now go to the second example. This is the one box given to you. In the box, 3 equal parts are made. How many equal parts are there? 3 equal parts are there. From the 3, 2 are the colored. From the 3, 2 are the colored. Understood? Now next. And 1 is remaining. 1 is not colored. So you want to write 2 upon 3. 2/3. Till here understood? Yes. Okay, now next, look at here, in the proper fraction, third one is circle there, okay? Yes, in the circle is divided into 10 equal parts. Circle is divided into how many equal parts? 10. How many equal parts? 10. Circle is divided into how many equal parts? 10 equal parts, okay? So now student, from the 10 parts, how many equal parts are colored? How many equal parts are colored? Yes, tell me. It is given also and the writing number also. Then also I am going to ask you, okay? Don't be think like this. Why teacher is asking? Answer is given to in front of that circle. And why teacher is asking to us the questions? Don't think like this. But I am going to ask you to each and every student deeply. That is color part also given and not color part also given. So how to write that? 7/10. 7/10. 7/10. 7/10. Very nice. This is the proper fraction. Okay. Understood the proper fraction. It's a simple. Yesterday also we learned the proper fraction. Yes or no? Tell me. Till here, anyone have doubt? Yes, students, till here, anyone have doubt? Proper fraction, till here, anyone have doubt? If suppose you have the doubt, then raise the hands. Otherwise, ask me the question in chat box. Till here, and everyone clear? Yes. Till proper fraction, everyone clear? Okay. Very nice, very nice. Good. So student, now my next turn, that is we will go to the improper fraction. Okay, we will go to the improper fraction. Improper fraction is totally opposite to the proper fraction. Understood what I'm going to tell you? Yes. Understood what I'm going to tell you? The improper fraction is totally opposite to the proper fraction. If suppose all students are ready with your study material, so definition write down in your notebook now itself. Write there proper fraction. The numerator is less than the denominator. Okay? Yes. After that, you want to write the examples there. Write down. Two examples write down. That means you will understood. It's a proper fraction. In proper fraction, the numerator is less than the denominator. What? The numerator is always less than the denominator. Understood? Yes. Now go to the improper fraction. What is the improper fraction? It's the opposite to the proper fraction. I told you. It's a totally opposite to the proper fraction. The numerator is larger than or equal to the denominator. Listen it properly. What is the definition? Everyone write down the definition in your notebook because at the last moment I'm going to ask you. The numerator is larger than or equal to the denominator. Okay, so that means 5 is given you. The numerator here and 2 is the denominator. So in the improper fraction, numerator is bigger and denominator is smaller. This difference everyone understood? Yes. Give me answer. Give me response. This difference everyone understood, proper and improper fraction. In the proper fraction, tell me numerator and denominator. What is the difference? In the proper fraction, tell me. Numerator is small, denominator is big. In which concept? In proper fraction. Understood? Understood, everyone? Okay. So, it's opposite to the improper fraction. Improper fraction is what? The numerator is big. Improper fraction. I'm going to explain you now improper fraction. Numerator is big. Denominator is small. Numerator is big. Denominator is small. Understood till here, everyone? Yes. Cleared, everyone? Proper and improper, cleared, everyone? Give me response in chat box. If suppose clear it is, then type capital O in chat box. Till here, everyone clear, then type capital O in chat box. Capital O. O. Only one student understood? Yes. O. I want O. If suppose the both concept clear. First of all, understood the difference between proper and improper. Understood the difference between proper and improper. Improper, what exactly we want? Yes, tell me student in chat box. In proper fraction, what we want exactly? Numerator is small, denominator is big. Understood? Numerator is small, denominator is big. Heard or not? Am I right? Yes, students, numerator is small, denominator is big. Am I right? So, improper, not understood. Okay, Manasvi, it's the opposite, beta. I'm going to explaining you. Improper, it's the opposite. Numerator is always big. And denominator is small. Understood? Now, look at here the example given to you. I'm going to show you the example. In improper fraction, one circle given to you, four equal parts are there. And these four parts are colored. So you want to write in proper fraction also and improper fraction, 4 upon 4, otherwise 4 by 4. Go to the second example. Okay. How many slides are there in one box? 3 slides are there. Good. So, 3 slides, that means 1, 2, 3, again 1, 2, 3. From the 3, how many are colored? Just tell me, student, how many are colored? From the, first of all, we want to write in the improper fraction, equal parts, how many are there? Understood? Improper fraction, we want to write downside the place of denominator. We want to write the equal parts and how many parts are color? How many parts are color? That number you want to write top side. Clear? Now look at here. In one box, 3 slides given to you. Equal parts are given to you. Again in one box, 3 slides given to you. Equal parts are given to you. But the one box is full colored and the second box only 2 slides are colored and 1 is remaining. That means total how many are colored? Total how many are colored? That is 5. So 5 divided by 3. 5 upon 3. 5 by 3. Understood? Go to the next example. In one circle, how many parts are there? Equal 4. Again, in one circle, how many parts are there? Equal 4. So no need to write the 4 plus 4, 8. We want to write the one number, that is 4, downside. But on the top side, we want to write the color part. How many are color parts are there? But the top side, how many are color parts are there? That altogether number you want to count and write down. 7 upon 4. 7 by 4. Understood? Yes, Manasri beta, improper fraction understood. Yes, tell me. If suppose you have doubt, then ask me in chat box. You have doubt, then ask me in chat box. Yes, 5 by 3. 5 by 3. Okay. Look at here.
how many equal parts are there? Don't count these two circles, these two box. Wait a second, I'm going to erase this. Look at here. Okay, 5 by 3. Understood? How many equal parts are there in one box? 3, in another box also 3, but don't count, don't add together. You want to write separate number, that is 3. But how many colored? The first box 3 slide full colored, second box 2 slide colored. So 3 plus 2. 3 plus 2, total how much? That is 5. Understood? 5. Yes, total 3 plus 2. 3 plus 2, total 5. That means 5 by 3. Clear now? Yes, till here anyone have doubt? Ask me. Freely and frankly ask me. Till here anyone have doubt? Yes, I want the answer. Till here anyone have doubt? Freely and frankly ask me. I'm going to clear your doubt. I'm going to explaining you why not understood that thing. So clear. Freely and frankly, I told you, I'm not going to hyper on you. Why are you asking me? How many times asking you the double questions? I'm going to repeat the answer. Don't worry. Freely and frankly, ask me. You have any doubt? I'm going to ask you very freely because at the last moment, I'm going to ask you the question. That's why I'm going to ask you very freely and frankly. Anyone have doubt? Ask me. Type in chat box. Otherwise, talk with the help of microphone. Yes, all are cleared. Now look at here, how many students are there in our classroom today? Total 48. From 48, how many are given the response? No doubt, only 7 students are given. That means another students have the doubt. So why you're not responding properly in chat box? That means I'm getting confused. You are not sending no doubt, otherwise clear it is. That means it is clear for me. Understood? Okay, no doubt. You all are understood. Good. Now go to the third one. Third one, it's the last one, mixed number. It's a mixed fraction. Okay? Third one, it's a mixed fraction, mixed number. Okay. So now look at here, student. Yes, who is raising the hand? Avnish, any problem, beta? Avnish. Yes, Avnish, any problem is there? So hands down. Anyone have problem? Raise the hand. Otherwise, hand should be down. Okay. Now I'm going to explaining you the last fraction, that is mixed number. Which number? Mixed number. What is exactly the mixed number? Mixed fraction. Okay. Look at here. I'm going to rough it. Wait a second. Okay. This is the mixed number. Okay. So what is exactly meaning of mixed number? What is the meaning? A number written as a whole number. Okay. A number written as a whole number with a proper fraction. Okay. A number. A number written as a whole number with a proper fraction. That means. Now, mixed fraction means they are given you to the mixed number. That is already I given the example. 2, after that 1 divided by 2. Okay, that is a mixed fraction. But the top side we learn the proper fraction, improper fraction not given in this type of number. Okay. Yes. Now third one you want. Yes. Third one our remaining. Now I'm going to explain you the third one. Yes. I'm going to explain you the third one. That is a mixed number. Okay. Now look at here. Mixed number means what? Okay. Good. Now look at here students. Two. After that 1 by 2 written there. Okay. 2, 1 by 2. So exactly this 2 means what? This 2 means how many box given to you? 1, 2. Understood? and this is the three, but third one full is not colored, so don't count third one. Only how many colored are there? That is here also given the example. In this circle example, one is like this, two is like this. Understood? Two. How two will come understood? Because this two square. Because this two square. Okay, how many square given to you? Yes, Manasvi beta. Now look at here. How many square given to you? Tell me how many square in first example. In first example, how many square given to you? Total, how many square given to you? Tell me the answer. Three, total, okay? But from this total, which are the full covered? Which are the full colored box are there? Which are the full colored? How many are the full colored? Yes, correct. It's absolutely correct. Two are the full colored, okay? And third one is? In third one box, one equal part is remaining, right? In third one box, one equal part is remaining, right? Yes. So 2y came. Yes, tell me student, 2y came because of this two box. Look at here. Because of this two box, one is this, two is this. Two full covered, two full colored. That's why here, 2 will come. Understood? That's why here 2 will come. Understood till here? Yes. Very nice. Because of this 2, here 2 number will come. Till here understood? Yes. Now, 1 upon 2. They are written 1 upon 2. Yes or no? So now I'm going to rub this last. That means I'm going to explaining you nicely. Okay, look at here now. Mixed fraction means what? There indicates the number. That is 2. After that 2 upon 3. 2 upon 3 y came. Tell me 2 upon 3. Tell me student 2 upon 3 y came. 3. This 3 means in this box, how many equal parts are there? Tell me. Yes. In this box, how many equal parts are there? Total 3. That means 3 is the denominator here. 3 is the what? Is the denominator here. Understood? 3y came because whole part. Whole means equal parts. You want to count it. Always I'm going to tell you equal parts you want to find out. So how many equal parts are there? 3. From the 3, how many are colored? From the 3, how many are colored? Yes, give me answer in chat box. Look at here now. Third. 3 written there. Okay, it's a denominator place. 3 is there. So why 3 came there? Tell me why 3? Because how many equal parts are there? Yes, I want answer. 8 colors are there. How it's possible? 8 colors, Sanika. 3 parts are there. In the one box, which I'm going to highlight. In the one box, when I'm going to highlight this box. In this box, how many equal parts are there? 3. From the 3, how many are colored? From the 3, how many are colored? Yes, Sapna teacher, mute yourself. Sapna teacher, mute yourself. Yes. 2/3. Understood? How many equal parts are there? 3. From the 3, 2 are the colored. Okay. Yeah. So that's why there came 2 upon 3, 2 divided by 3. 2 upon 3, 2 by 3. Understood why 2 by 3 came there? Yes, in mixed fraction, everyone understood why 2 by 3 came there. Everyone understood? Tell me. Everyone clear? If suppose clear, then type O in chat box. Yes, if suppose clear, then type O in chat box. O, capital O. Yes. Capital O. I want capital O. Yes, students, give me answer properly. I want capital O. I am waiting for your answer. How many understood why there 2 by 3rd came? Why there 2 upon 3 came? Everyone understood, then type capital O. Yes. Okay. So now next example. I given you the next example also. Yes. Now look at here. Yes, Adarsh beta, you not understood. Okay, again, look at here. I'm going to explain you. I'm going to rub first of all. I'm going to clear the first of all. Okay. Your concentration should be on the lecture. Okay. Look at here. It's a mixed number, mixed fraction. In the first one, we already learned 2 and 2 by 3 is there. So how 2 by 3 is came? 2. First of all, I'm going to explaining you this 2. Why 2 is there? Okay. This, how many box are there? 1, 2 and 3. How many box are there? Yes, tell me how many box are there. I want answer. Who has not understood the concept? Wait a second. I'm going to announce that name. Adarsh Ram. Adarsh Yadav beta. Adarsh. Yes. Are you ready? Adarsh Yadav. Okay. Adarsh beta, look at here. How many boxes are there? First of all, tell me. Total box, how many are there? Yes, 3 are there. Okay. From the all 3 boxes are colored. So full colored are there? 3 boxes? No. So how many are colored? 2 boxes are colored properly, full colored. Okay. So you want to write here 2. Understood now 2 why came here? Why 2 is there? Everyone understood? Wait a second. Who is there? Raising the hands. Wait a second. Okay. Look at here. My question is 2 here 2 came. Okay. So understood now. Yes, Tanishka beta, I'm going to solve the Adarsh question. After that, raise the hand, okay? It's a disturbing. It's not visible properly on the screen. That's why don't raise the hands. Why 2 is came there? Adarsh understood now. After that, I'm going to explain you the next. Why 2 is there understood? Because of how many color boxes are there? Full color boxes, 2. Okay? And our third one box is not full color. Our third one box is not full colors. So we want to write the now description of third box. So in the third box, how many slides are there? How many equal parts are there? Tell me in the third box. Yes, students, in the third box, yes, Adarsh, how many equal parts are there? 3 parts are there. Okay. And from the 3, how many are colored? From the 3, how many are colored? Yes, I want the answer. From the 3, 2 are colored. So your answer is what? 2 upon 3. Understood? 2 upon 3. So now look at here. Here already given to you 2 upon 3. Wait a second. Yes. Look at here now. Understood? 2 upon 3. How came? Understood? 2 came because 3 squares are there. Is 2 square are colored, then we say that number 2 upon 3. Now clear? Yes, very nice. Avnish, good. Adarsh, now clear, beta? Yes. If suppose again not clear, then ask me, I'm going to explaining you. Okay, now understood. Yes. Who having doubt here? Tanisha, maybe, no? She is raising the hands. Where is she now? Yes, students. I am going to ask you. Anyone have doubt? Tanishka, beta. Tanishka. Tanishka.